usually guys get it for a day. And so I got it from Jarrett's Hole in Saskatoon. There was my aunt, who's a nurse in Saskatoon, had someone that she knew who was a quadriplegic, and he met us there at the airport and had his chance to hang out with the couple. And then there was also some other people around before we flew to Calgary that were there. And the interesting thing about the Cup is it turns almost anyone that comes in contact with it into this grinning little child. And so, you know, there were people everywhere that, you know, hey, can I take a picture? Yeah, yeah, no problem. So it was kind of hard to stay on our schedule, but we quickly flew to Calgary. We had we rented out a place that had about 130 people there. And the keepers of the Cup were really happy because the venue that we had bowling alleys, had arcade games and things like that. And they were actually happy. They came up to me after that evening and said, you know, we appreciate that we actually had something to do, and we just didn't have to stare at the Cup the whole time and make sure people were being respectful. That evening, we got the chance to take it back to our friend's place. And when things aren't getting rowdy, the Cup has actually a midnight curfew usually. And when things aren't getting rowdy, they let you take it. And I said, you know, like how long? They're like, well, you can have it all night for this. And I said, well, what do you guys normally do? They said, guys actually normally kick out their wives and they sleep with it. And I don't know about that. But we stayed at a friend's place that are huge Oiler fans. And
obviously, and wonderful people.
So we're sitting around the fire. It's 2:30 in the morning at their place. And being Oiler fans, I said, well, you're not going to see this for decades, so, you know, drink it all in. The next morning, we flew back to Saskatoon. We went to Rostrum. I invited all the minor hockey teams from the area to have their chance with the Cup. And then we went up to the lake. We have a cabin in Christopher Lake, just north of Prince Albert. And then we started the party. And I'm happy to say that the Cup got yanked for me at midnight that night because things were really getting on a roll. But there was just a really cool experience. Our kids, they wanted, the only thing they wanted to do was eat cereal out of the Stanley Cup. So we did that. You know, grandparents were drinking out of it. We did that. And we did so many fun things with it. And it's an amazing trophy. There's a lot of history to it. And we had a lot of fun with it.